Hello, I am Osman İnan. I am PhD student at Namık Kemal University, Agricultural Economy Department. Welcome to my presentation. Dr. Sema Konyalı and I prepared an article which is name of evaluation of KÖYDES and KÜREÇEK projects in terms of rural development. I hope it will be useful. Firstly, I want to talk about the aims of the study. There have been significant changes in the management of rural areas in recent years. In this study, some information was given about long-term rural development projects and rural areas regulations. With this study, it was aimed to better understand the rural areas regulations and the management of rural areas in recent years. And the result of the study were evaluated in detail. I have enumerated some important rural area projects and regulations in recent years. First, the village infrastructure support project started in 2005. Secondly, metropolitan municipal Law No. 63 and 60 was regulated in 2012. And then, thirdly, Metropolitan Municipality Law No. 63 and 60 started to appreciate after from 2014 elections. And then, Rural Infrastructure Support Projects started in 2017. And then, Rural Neighborhood Regulation was made in 2021. When we look at the rural development projects in the previous periods, we can say something briefly. First, the center village. The more populated village was chosen as the center. It was developed socially and economically. Surrounding villages benefited from its sophistication. The other project, community village development, it was aimed to ensure that the village that requests support from the central administration was self-sufficient and the willing participation of the local people. The other project, village town, aimed to prevent rapid migration from rural areas to urban areas and to develop these areas in economic and social terms by bringing agriculture, health, education, and infrastructure services to the people living in rural areas. The other projects, the primary village was applied in Istanbul and Ankara between 1963 and 1965, and it was aimed to affect the surrounding village from the central village activities. We can refer to other models applied in rural development. For example, agricultural city, multi-directional rural planning, return to the village. In addition to this, regional incentive measures can be seen as a rural development method applied in underdeveloped regions. Village infrastructure support project was started in all Turkey in 2005, except Istanbul and Kocaeli. The Ministry of Interior, the Ministry of Finance and the State Planning Organization have been transferred into a comprehensive infrastructure program in coordination. With the KÖYDES project, the services are carried out in 51 provinces, 18,280 villages with a population of nearly 5 million people, according to the 2019 census. Ve Koides projects aims to solve the problems of villages that lack rural infrastructure. It focuses primarily for road and drinking water, and it prepares agricultural infrastructure. It provides activities such as disposal of wastewater in rural areas, providing agricultural irrigation, and collects solid waste are also carried out with the project. And the project aims to make efficient use of local facilities and solve them in a short time and with the least cost by means of provincial spatial administrations and village service unions under the leadership or of local governors. If we look 2012 year and Lavno 63 and 60 and after, when considered in 2012 in Turkey, it was statistically demonstrated that 77.3% of the population lived in provincial and district centers, and 22.7% lived in towns and villages. With a legal arrangement brought by the Metropolitan Municipality Law numbered 63 and 60, 16,800 villages were added to the municipal boundaries and transformed into neighborhood status. With this arrangement, Turkey's administrative structure has changed by 52%. In 2016, the population in provincial and district centers increased to 92.30%, and the population in towns and villages decreased 7.7%. The metropolitan Lavno 63.60 brought significant change into rural areas. With this arrangement made, the legal personality of village and town municipalities in all new established metropolitan cities with expanding borders was abolished. The villages in this place have turned into neighborhoods, and the municipalities have joined the municipality of the district to which it is applied with the town name. The law could bring some disadvantages. Service quality could have deteriorated, financial difficulties could increase, the budget of municipalities were already in difficult situation, it was important to abolish the village budget. Some of problems continued. Some taxes, fees, and participant fees that needs to be collected were increased. It was postponed for 5 years. Water and water waste charges, poverty tax, project costs, and other financial obligations related to construction have been increased, but it was postponed for 5 years. Establishment of Investment Monitoring and Coordination Directorate were established in new metropolitan municipalities after the 2014 local elections, with the regulation made by Lavno 60 and 60 in 2012. Metropolitan municipality boundaries have been updated as a provincial administrative boundaries. In metropolitan cities, the separation of duties and powers have been remade. The authorities of municipalities have been increased to meet the common needs of the people. Special provincial administrations have been closed and shortly UCOPs have been established. Today, UCOPs are located in 30 metropolitan municipalities. The management and administration of the Investment Monitoring and Coordinating Directorate is carried out by the governor or the deputy governor appointed by the governor. The Investment Monitoring and Coordination Department is responsible for the coordination, supervision, and monitoring of all kinds of assistance and support provided by the central administration and for their implementation in case of emergency. Rural Infrastructure Support Projects was initiated under the coordination of the General Directorate or Provincial Administration as of 2017, hosted by the Ministry of Interior, and in 2017 Services was carried out into the rural areas of 28 metropolitan municipalities, except Istanbul and Kocaeli provinces. The Kırdes project has been included the service responsibility of the rural area metropolitan municipality with the transformation of the villages into neighborhood status with the law no 63 and 60. Within the scope of Kırdes project, with the allowance from the center, it is used primarily in the construction of the roads of the rural villages and towns in the metropolitan cities that are transformed into neighborhoods. For the expenditures under the Kırdes project, an appropriation is allocated from the central budget. Allowance is made available by Investment Monitoring and Coordination Departments. The issue of rural areas in metropolitan municipalities is still a matter of debate. An arrangement was made in late 2020, but it did not meet the need. After 6 months, a new arrangement was made in April 2021. With this arrangement, it is hoped to solve some important problems of rural areas, especially the definition of rural areas and rural settlements. With the rural neighborhood and rural settlement area regulation is described, rural neighborhood and rural settled areas were defined. How to detect rural residential area were defined. How the metropolitan city council takes decision were defined. Procedures to be carried out by municipalities have been arranged. Exemptions granted to rural neighborhoods and rural settlements have been regulated. Taxes, fees, wastewater and drinking water usage, expenditures, etc. topics were arranged. When we look at the results of the study in Kırdes project, it has been positive to determine the main objective of improving the physical infrastructure, which is the most fundamental element among the rural and social development factors. As a financial and implementation model, the Kırdes project is also very important in terms of ensuring the active participation of local governments in rural development studies. It has a very important place in rural development approach by determining the problems in rural areas on site and providing services to these areas with on site research transfer. Kardeş project was created to eliminate the negative consequences of metropolization, which could not respond to the infrastructure needs in rural areas. Because with its current structure, metropolitan cities were far from the ability and capacity to meet these needs in the rural areas. The regulation introduced by Law No. 72 and 54 on public financial management on control law and amending some laws in 2020 could not fully clarify the issues such as rural neighborhoods and rural settlements. As a matter of fact, there have been problems in determining the status of rural areas. So it has been calculated that the rural neighborhoods and rural settlement area regulation will bring solutions to the problems in practice in the official gazette No. 31,455 date 15 April 2051. Last sentence. It should be well known that it is only possible to eliminate these problems in the rural area to understand the separation of powers to bring quality service to the rural areas and to make rural development healthy. Thank you very much for listening to me.